And Ian Perry, I want to explain something about hoses. I started a DVD and I had to stop it because we had some problems because we were using garden hoses for aquaponics and there was some discussion that is carcinogenic and not. So I actually did some research and found out what the correct word is here. I'm just going to teach you a little bit about hoses and tubing and stuff. This is a typical five and three-eighths, I believe, but it's typical garden hose used for non-potable water, meaning you don't drink from it. You can use it to water your lawn, but it's not for personal consumption, making of food. So when you're making an aquaponic system, do not use regular garden hose. There are different kinds of hoses you can use, and I will explain the benefits and the disadvantages of it. This is vinyl tubing. This is 59 cents a foot. It is rated for food. You'll find that in some of the soda machines and things like this. It's rated for food for your drinking. In aquaponics, it's good, except it gets green algae in it very quickly, but it's very good to see what's going on in a teaching environment. If it was going to be completely dark, you wouldn't have to see it, but it's very palpable. It moves in different areas. You can use this. This is good because it's food service certified. The other kind of hose that we can have is PVC pipe. Now, there's different kinds of PVC pipe. Believe it or not, there is even a flexible PVC pipe, as you see here. This is a half inch. This, again, is rated for food and water. You can get this. This happens to be $2.49 a foot. It's a little more expensive because it bends. In some cases, when you're making something, it might be good to be, if it's expensive to get little things to do corners. I like to use this sometimes. The other kind that we have, actually two more, we have this kind of tubing, which is a clear tubing. Again, this is not food service rated, but it's inexpensive. I don't recommend to use it because it hasn't been tested, but it is clear plastic. And the problem, again, like the other one, it would get algae. So I would stay away from that. Stay with the food service. And the last one is PVC piping that you do get in the store. This is 14 cents a foot, so we're going to use this in making it. It's the least expensive. Joints cost on average of up 25 cents to a dollar, depending on what you want to do with the joint to turn it. Again, this is half inch. You can get this at Home Depot. I'm going to include at the end of the website or in papers where you can get this. This is Aquato Ecosystems. They have a website. You can buy the flexible tubing, which is nice. Also, they also sell this at Aquatics Eco in Orlando. They sell this. But for right now, we're going to show you how to make a system here. It's going to be a continuous flow system as I did before, but we did something different. We, again, changed the tubing, so I'm going to be going over this step by step. I also am going to be telling you the prices of the things as we do it, and you can see it's not very expensive. It is the simplest system that you can make to feed. In fact, that is a system that we use here at the school now. We don't use anything else that you see here. This is what you use. Now, let's begin with this, talking about the equipment that we're going to be having. Let me move my chair out of the way. The first things that we need in aquaponic system is water, something to hold water. Now, I recommend, this is $10, and you can get two of them, and they do work. You can get something bigger for $15, and you can go bigger and bigger. What I did is I went to the smallest one. I'm going to show you how to make a two-barrel type system in our aquaponics. It's the most simplest system. It does work. And I'm going to show you how to do it inexpensively. I've been asked, where do I get the parts? Now, I'm going to show you as if you had to buy your parts everywhere. You can search for cheaper parts on Craigslist. You can borrow from your friends. You can scrounge your house. But I'm going to show you how to make it if you had to buy every single item. The first thing I did was I went to Walmart, and I got two kiddie pools, $10 a piece. As you see, I pre-drilled a hole in it. I'll explain that later. I got two of them. That's $20 for the system so far. Pallets, you're going to need a pallet. What I use a pallet. Now let me explain this in a little more detail. In order to have a system as this, as you notice, I have the pool on top of something and a pool on the bottom. I like to have it separated. Now you can use a table. You can use, as in this case, I have two 50-gallon drums. I'm using a pallet on top of it. You can buy the pallet for approximately $5, but most of the times, if you ask for it, they'll give it to you. But it's $5. At most feed stores, they'll get you a pallet, just a pallet. Search around for it, but it is about $5 per. And don't get a new one because they are anywhere from $25 and more. You need to have it elevated. That's the first two things that we're going to talk about right here. And as I go further, we'll talk about the other parts. As you noted, it is elevated. Now the first thing that we're going to do, if you just follow me with the camera, we're going to put the pool. Now when you place the pool, it's important to remember something. Don't put the pool with the edge of it or whatever container you use over the edge because it's going to droop with water, that waste. Look at that. You want to find, that's the reason I like the pallet, because it's nice and wide, it's also very strong. So what you can do, you see what I did here? Notice I'm looking at all the edges. I'm looking at it very clearly. It's over. Now, I had drilled a 1-inch hole, because a half inch, excuse me, because the piping I'm using today is a half inch. It is $14.46, so let's say 15 cents a foot. It's the least, it's inexpensive. It's foods rated food safety drinking water. So what I'm going to do to make sure it's placed correctly, I have a piece of pipe here. I'm going to put in a hole, make sure it fits right in a hole. See, it's going to go right there, so I know it's in the right place. I'm also going to look. I'm going to bring it in just a little because I want it on the edge. I want to make sure I'm completely on the edge. And then I'm going to look in here again to make sure I go. So this is pretty good. Right there. That's a good spot. It's in the middle, fully supported. Now, these are the first two items that you're going to use. Now, in order to put this pipe, and I'll explain how that works, you're going to need what they call as a bulkhead fitting. Now, bulkhead fitting, it is, you can get different styles. I have one right here. This style here is, let me show you real close. This is what it looks like. This is a bulkhead fitting. Let me explain how it works. It's really a simple concept, so if you decide to use something else, you go ahead and try to use it. It has a washer. This is the build, this is the wall of whatever it is. You put this in like so. Whoops. And it stays on there so you can stick a pipe through, as you can see. Hence bulkhead. These are $4.50 at Equal Aquatic Systems, which I'll leave the website. You need three. But for this two-barrel system, we're going to use one and then two. You'll see why we need three. We're going to use one. So far we're at $20, $25 right now just for this. So here's what I did. I drilled the hole. I'm going to put this in right here. Let me show you how it is. There's the hole. I take this and I start screwing it in. Notice the rubber grommets there. Now it's a little stiff, is what I wanted, a little stiff. Reason being, it's got to have a nice seal. If it's nice and loose, now if you cut it, you decide to, you make the hole a little larger, you're going to have problems. So it's better to do it on a side of caution. And it's better doing the side of caution and get the hole too small. You can always make it bigger. Okay? Right there. Okay, see what I'm doing here? I'm tightening this up now. This is the bulkhead fitting going to it, and this is what it looks like inside. Now, I have it flush inside for a reason, instead of having this part out here, or in here, because if I want to drain it, it will go flat. It's more likely to drain more. It's also a very good guide to be where it is with this. Now, let me show you. For this particular one, the way I have it height, I'll measure it. Just one moment. Let me just measure it and tell you how long it was or is. This happens to be 38 inches long. Now you can do the math at 14 cents a foot. 38 inches is, you know, is 3 feet 2 inches. So it's not very expensive. Now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take this half inch pipe and I'm going to stick it through here because I need to know where it is. Because it's there. See that? Just lost my drink, by the way. See, I put this in, make sure I screw it in all the way. Look at that. We also make sure it's nice and straight. It's nice and secure. Now, if it leaks a little bit, don't worry because it's going into the pool. Now, the next thing you need, which I have right here, this cost at Home Depot, it is an inch on top, half an inch on the bottom expander. This cost, I believe, 68 cents at Home Depot. I purchased it for that. I cut a piece of PVC inch and a half. I'm staying with inch and a half. The reason, let me explain how this works. This is a Venturi principle. The water goes in here with this drain. But remember how you have a sink, and when you pour the water in the sink, it whirls around real fast? Well, that's what it's going to do here. It's going to whirl around real fast, but it's going to draw air. When it draws air, it puts air where the fish move in. I stick it in the hole here. That is completely done. Now let me show you what it looks like. This is what it looks like. Just to see. As you can see, I put it right here. See the hole right there? This goes in. It's like this. Goes in like so. And then this is nice and, I want this a little bit straight. And that's good right there. See, it goes right in. And that's what it will look like. Now, let me put the back here so you can see what's up. The next thing that we're going to do, very important, is we need the water pump. Now I'll explain this. This is $15. Let me show you how it works. Comes with a pre-filter on it. A strainer right here that fits right in. Of course, it comes with a suction pad. $15. And this is again from Aqua Ecosystems in Orlando. Again, I'll leave the website for you to buy it. $15. So as you can see, 20 and 20 is 40. 15 is 35. Plus the other part, we're still well under $60. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place this right here because we're going to need the water pump. Now this leads to the next part of the project. Very important part. Now, I'm going to, again, what I did is I had another piece of PVC pipe. I bought two sections of 10 foot, would cost me approximately $3.